Hi guys, today we're just going to do an actual review of our Bundutop tent that we've had for a while now. We thought it was about time we just did a bit of an actual updated review on the Bundutop tent. Had it a bit over 9 months, nearly 10 months now. Done around 30 nights. Bit more than that in it. Just thought it was about time to do a bit of a pros and cons and a bit of a detailed actual review on the tent.
Yep, and at the moment, as you can see, the tent's not on the car. We've taken it off because we're getting the roof rack all powder coated. We're just going to go through what we found. These are obviously our personal opinions, and everybody's would be different depending on your setup and what you like and what you don't like. But this is just personally what we've found with the amount of nights that we've had in the tent and the way we like to camp. So the first pro that we really like for this specific tent is that you can get access into the tent in every single side. We like that we are able to, say, put our awning out and we can get up on the other side. We could get up at the back. We could even climb up at the front if we wanted to. So if we were putting another awning on the other side or anything like that, we could still have access on any side we like.
And that also allows good ventilation from every side, being able to have it open on all four.
Yep.
One of the big pros, obviously, with this tent is it's fully automatic, electric. You just undo the four buckles, hold the button, and up it goes. There's no poles to set up, no anything. It's just really quick, up, down, really easy, really simple.
The other thing that's really good as well is the awning puts itself out as well, so it covers all sides, but it also has no poles. It just goes up and the awning goes out. It's awesome. It's wired up for solar, and it's also got all the electrics inside, so you can power your phone, you can turn the light on and off, and you've got two fans either side. So it's basically all you need up in there, already wired and ready to go.
One of the pros we've found with the tent is actually the canvas itself. It's quite a thick, dark colour, so we've noticed compared to other tents that we've had, it is quite dark in there in the morning. Even with the sun on the tent, it doesn't sort of wake you up straight away. One of the first tents we had was a cheaper model rooftop tent, and it was like a yellow thin canvas, so it would just highlight the sun as soon as it hit it, whereas this one's fairly nice and dark.
Yeah, and the other reason that I find that this is really dark too is obviously because this whole top is hard, so it's not a heap of canvas. The whole top is obviously not going to be absorbing the light like the canvas would, so it is a lot darker and it's nice, you can sleep in a little bit longer. Another really good thing about this is you can have a bit of weight on the roof. They take about an extra 20 kilos, so you can mount a solar panel, and we're hoping to do that on this one in the coming few months.
Okay, so one that's actually a bit of a pro and a con as well is the weight of the tent. So compared to basically all the other hard shell rooftop tents, this is actually the lightest one we found. This is around 60 kilos. A lot of the others are up around 100 kilos. So the pro is that it's fairly light compared to those. The con obviously is that you do still have 60 kilos mounted up on your roof. But this one compared to the others being spread across the whole roof, it does actually feel a bit better, so we're pretty happy with the weight of it.
One of the really good things that we found that we didn't really notice would be a really good pro is we can keep our bedding inside, and we used to be able to keep our bedding inside the other rooftop tents that we've had, but because this is obviously just flat and it goes up, the bedding's made and everything's in place instead of your bed being folded in half and then having to open it up and make it all and all of that. So it just goes up and it's ready to go, and you can just climb in and go to bed. So with the mesh on all of the doors, the mesh is actually a little bit wider. All of the little holes are actually a little bit more spaced out than some of the other tents that we've had in the past. So we think that there might be a possibility that really tiny little insects might be able to get through, such as sandflies and things. But saying that, we haven't yet had that happen.
The tent itself is actually quite bulky. When we're looking at others like the Alu cab, the way they're shaped sort of makes it seem a bit less bulky. This one is fairly chunky and just the way it's designed. But overall it's not too much of an issue for us.
The mattress, although it is really quite thick, for us it's pretty dense. So we found that just to get a little bit more softness on the top, we've had to find like stuff to put over the top, whether it be a mattress protector or an eggshell foam topper or something like that, because we just find it's a little bit hard, even though it does give you that support.
One that Steph mentioned in the video when we first got the tent was the ladder. The original ladder itself, and also the way it attached to the tent, we were really unhappy with. Just having round rungs that were actually really slippery and stuff, and it just hooked into a side tray. But we have changed that. We did a video on how we sort of changed it up, and so once that was changed, it's not an issue for us anymore. We're really happy with the way it works now.
The only other thing is it is a bit loud, so obviously there's a winch inside, and as it goes up and down it does have a distinct sound. It doesn't last long because it doesn't take long to set up or pack up, but if you were camping close to other people and you were setting up or packing up really early or really late, it might be a little bit annoying for other people. It might wake people up.
Overall, obviously with the pros and the cons, we are really happy with the tent. There's not a great deal we still want to change. The ladder was a big thing. As soon as we changed that, we were really happy with that. Compared to other tents that we've used, the biggest pro for me is just how quick and easy this is to put up and pack away. We've done a lot more quick one-night camps, and if we don't need sort of to put the awning and stuff like that up, our setup and pack up is just so quick, like less than 5 minutes for everything. Once we have our chairs out, put the tent up, we're pretty much ready to go. So that'd be the biggest thing I've noticed, is just how much quicker and easier it is. So for quick one-nighters, or if you were doing a trip where you're only staying, like arriving late and then going early, that sort of stuff, this is perfect for that.
Yeah, and just to add to that, that's probably the main reason that I have really enjoyed owning this tent over the last couple that we've had, is just the amount of time. And the other thing is that because you don't have to have things that you've got to remember to set this up, it's a lot less frustrating when you get somewhere and realize that you have forgotten something. Because with our last tent, we'll get there and say forget the poles that put the windows out, and then you can't get them up and stuff. This, obviously you can't forget things, so you just pull up, set it up, and it's all done. So yeah, we find that just such a big benefit. So thanks so much for tuning in to another one of our videos, and we'll see you in our next one. Bye.
See ya.